Hello everyone, in today's TOEFL writing class, I learned about the comprehensive writing. 就是这个综合性写作。那首先这个综合性写作呢，它有一个这个模板。这个模板呢，大概就是写四段。第一段呢是开头呢，然后第一段开头，然后后面三段呢分别写三个分论点。那么每一段呢都可以都有一些这个固定的这个结构句式可以套用。比如说开头第一段我们可以套用什么呢，还有这个 contrary to the belief in the passage that， 这样这个阅读的这个立场，然后这样这个 the professor asserts that， 当然这个听力的这个立场。然后第二段呢可以说 to begin with according to the writer， 这样这个阅读的第一个分论点。然后这个分论点呢应该是一个概括，这样一个同义替换，总共有15个词。这个概括呢，一般主要是从这个阅读第一句来摘取，然后也需要进行一些同义替换，是吧？可能把一些名词换成另一个词，能进行词性的替换，比如用把名词换成动词，某个词组，或者是那种主被动的替换，把主动变成被动，或者把这个什么把一个从句变成简单句，这样进行替换。15个词，这个要尽量比较凝练，并且能概括到所有的要点。然后我们接下去说这个模板，就是下一句话是 conversely the lecturer states that， 加上那个听力的这个论点，然后再加上听力的这个解释以及听力的具体的例子。它这个重点就是把听力的那个讲清楚一下，这个尽量详细一些。然后下一段呢是另一个模板，比如说 in addition based on the reading，像这个阅读的这个第二个分论点，然后是呢 on the contrary the speaker points out the fact that， 像那个听力的第二个分论点，然后呢还是 finally in the light of the reading passage， 像这个阅读的第三个分论点，像这个 by contrast the lecture giver reasons that， 可以加什么，加听力的第三个分论点。那这个就是这样一个这个主要的一个模板。哦，我们可以其实每一个模板都是可替换的。刚才呢只是一种结构。我们可以把这个模板呢都是就是可以进行替换的。它有很多的词啊，有各种各样的组合。如果避免重复的话呢，就可以有各种的组合。比如如果要说这个阅读，说的什么阅读部分怎么说呢，可以说 the author, the writer, 或者 the passage, the reading passage。或者是听力部分的话呢，可以怎么说呢？就听力是怎么说呢？比如 the speaker, the lecturer, the professor, the announcer, the lecture giver， 或者直接说 the lecturer, the speech， 这都是可以的。那如果说要反对怎么说呢？用听力反对阅读，比如 oppose, object, controvert, defend, counter, contradict, refute, disagree with, be against， 这样的一些。那如果说根据呢，比如说 according to the passage， according to the speaker， 或者是 in accordance with， based on， in terms of， in the light of， as for， when it comes to， 还有就是然而表对比，比如 while， whilst， whereas， yet， however， conversely， on the contrary， by， contrast， in contrast， nevertheless， nonetheless， on the other hand， 还有比如说这个同时，比如 whileWhen, as, just as, at the same time, meanwhile, simultaneously， 这讲说的对比，什么 compared to 啊， compared with 啊， in comparison with， different from， relative to， 这种让步就是 though， although， in spite of the fact that， 因为这个听力经常都是就第一段先让步，先承让，从阅读第一阅读呢，它有部分，它有一定的这个什么论据啊，会基础事实而正确，但它是不能够证明它的观点，就是可以用这样的让步。那表示引用的话呢，可以说是 described in the passage， depicted in， demonstrated in， revealed in， pointed out in， shown in， emphasized by， presented by， announced by， like this。 还有一些重要的词组，比如说这个研究调查， further studies， closer researches， 或者发明发现，New findings, new discoveries, new inventions， 就是其他的什么解释 ，alternative explanation, alternative theory， 或者反方的证据 ，counter example, Found evidence， 或者说这个质疑驳斥 ，challenge objection refutation， 断言声称你什么 allegation claim assertion， 或者评论解释 remark comment， 错误缺陷 fault weakness mistake error。它这个形容词的话呢，有一些，比如说 be contradictory。Be conflicted, be opposing, be contrary, be opposite to, be different from。 那副词的话呢，就是这种可以词组的这种呢，可以叫 in contrast, conversely, however, actually, in fact, indeed。 然后呢，再说一些句型。句型呢，主要是两类，一个是第一段的句型，一个是后面三段的这个主体句的句型。那首段句型可以有什么呢？主要是就是之前的这些词组啊，可以进行一定的组合，然后就形成一些句型，比如说。The professor discusses something which differs from the main idea of the reading. Contrary to the belief in the passage that something, the professor says that something. The professor refutes the viewpoint shown in the passage that something by saying that something. The professor made the point that something. The reading, in contrast, held an opposite view by stating that something. According to the lecturer,something. This contradicts the point in the reading that something. The professor argues that something. There is different form. This is different from the reading which states that something. Contrary to the belief in the passage that something. The professor asserts that something. The author of the passage points out that something. While the lecturer notes that something. Both textsdeal with something. The text clearly states that something. In the lecture, however, the professor holds a view that something. 这个呢就是这个开口段的这个主要句型。还有呢，这个主体段呢也可以进行可以有一些句型。比如呢 ，the first contradicting fact is something. In the lecture, it is said that another problem with something is that the third aspect involves.那个第二组是什么呢 ？Contrary to the argument in the passage that professor states that the lecturer refutes the idea that speaker explains that the professor also offers a different attitude towards. He says that foremost the passage states that, on the contrary, the lecturer states that this directly contradicts what the passage suggests.Furthermore, the passage suggests that, however, the speaker argues that this is another part where the lecture goes against the reading. Like this. And what should be mentioned is that the passage contains that. Is that the passage contains that. This is contrary to the claim in the lecture that. Or while the author claims that the lecture points out the fact that, whereas the author argues that the author was the lecturer holds an opposing view. The lecturer says that the final point on which the author and the lecturer disagree with each other is whether the lecturer reasons that. 它是一个主体状的一个句型。So here are all of the comprehensive writing employable.The most important thing is to to write every detail of your listening. So your score is mainly determined by the listening part. How much information you have written down when you are listening. So the most important thing is just to take notes as fast as possible when listening. To take the most important notes.Yeah. Sometimes, unusually, in listening, every argument may have two parts. Sometimes it is two parts. If you can write down these two parts, take notes of these two parts when listening. And then after listening, when writing, you can extend these notes into a paragraph. That is okay. It is easy to organize the points in the reading part because it's just need to, you can read the passage with writing. And for the structure, you can just use the sentences as the structures listed above. Just need to remember them and write them down when having the examination. So the most important part, the most core part is listening. You need to listen carefully. You not only need to listen carefully and understand the meanings of the lecturer, but also that you need to write, take notes as fast as possible. You need to balance these two things at the high school. And so it's the TOEFL writing class today. Thank you for watching.